All right, so let's get started. So I want to talk a little bit about teaching switch activities. So, and the reason that my joke is beyond the pink pig is because so often our students that we're working on getting switch activities for, we give them some type of stuffed toy or like the penguin race or something, and they have that toy or two or three toys that they get to use kind of throughout the year. And those are great for one or two times, but there's not a lot of variety. And if you look at, if you're gonna learn something new and you're gonna generalize it in a variety of settings, doing a variety of activities, you really need to make sure you're adding some variety to your switch skills. You also wanna make them like crazy fun and outrageous as possible, so that they're like highly motivating to kids. And, you know, initially, I mean, the first few times the pig or the dinosaur or the dog that flips might be like very motivating, but that's going to get old pretty soon because you know what's going to happen. So there's definitely a purpose for those, but you want to make sure that you're switching those out with some things that are a little bit different and more engaging. So we are going to not have any of those in this webinar. And then on February 22nd, I'm going to be doing another webinar that is looking at switch activities for art. Everyone can do art. So none of these are going to have art activities. So we have a whole next month, a whole set of different fun things you can do for art. I love kind of coming up with clever and creative ideas. And when we're done, if you've got some things that you've used, please share them with me and I will make sure they get added to this Google Doc, because I know there are a lot of people on, it's like we have 33 people currently on, and I know you guys all have some wonderful ideas. So I'm gonna start with talking a little bit about making PowerPoint scanning activities. And before I show you the activity I created, I have to tell you my Microsoft Office has been testy the last couple of weeks. And so it is not working how I would like it to work, but I'm going to show you kind of how to create it. The link on the page here is a webinar from a school in Britain. And she goes step by step by step. It's like 18 minutes long. And she goes step by step with how to do it. She's using a slightly older version of PowerPoint, but you can still find all the features if you hunt a little bit. There's one feature, and I'll show you when you get there, where you have to create a special slideshow, a custom slideshow, that you can't do, and if someone plays with this and figures it out, let me know, but you can't do it in Google Slides the way that we need to do it to make this work. So unfortunately, Google Slides is just going to be like a page turning, you know, in a PowerPoint. So you could do some activities there, in a Google Doc. So I am going to minimize this for a second and open up the PowerPoint. So we're going to go up here. So when I was watching the video, as you can see over here, there are three of the same slides, and I was having a really hard time figuring out why we needed three of the same slides. Let me move my little guy down here. Maybe he'll let me go. Okay. So I was having a really hard time trying to figure it out. But when you go through PowerPoint, as you're hitting the space bar, and I'll put it in play here in a minute, you're hitting the space bar, it moves it through slides. So the red surrounding this, when I hit the space bar, is going to move to the next slide. And the red, as you can see, moves around here. And then when you hit the space bar, it moves around and gets to this one. So each slide is an entire button. So anywhere they click on this slide, it is going to move to the bow video. And these are some animated shorts. And I love using animated shorts because there's no words. And so it's a perfect time to be modeling their AAC and chatting about what they're seeing. And, you know, there are so many wonderful core words you can be modeling with this. So I really, really love doing these animated shorts because the kids love them and it gives you the opportunity to, you know, do some talking about what's happening. So back to this. So the piece that you need to happen for this to work efficiently for switch users is if I hit this button and I hit my switch once and I'm here. I'm sorry, hit my switch once and I move here. I hit my switch once and I move here. And I'm like, no, I really wanted to watch the first one. I need to be able to loop right back up and start here. So I've tried, I've had my instructional tech try. I've had assistive tech specialists who use Google in other districts, and we cannot get that custom little loop there. So what happens in Google Slides is you just keep going through the slides. So this slide is linked to slide 4. This slide is linked to slide 5. And this slide is linked to slide 6. So you can input a video into PowerPoint and you can set it to where it'll play right when it starts. That's what I'm having trouble with today. I had set this up on my work computer and I've moved it over to my personal computer and spent some time this afternoon trying to fix it. And I think YouTube must have gotten blocked or at work or for these kind of activities on YouTube got blocked. So my videos aren't playing. So another option that I think if I were making this again is I would play the video on my computer and screen record it. So then I don't have to worry about, you know, if the Wi-Fi is off or, and it would just come up. So I think that in the future, that's the step that I would do differently. But let me show you kind of how it moves through. So here I am, I'm gonna hit my space bar. And as you see, it moves me through. And let's look at Fishing with Sam. And what should happen is this should immediately start playing. And unfortunately, like I said, Microsoft Office has not been my friend this week. And then when you hit the switch again, you go back to that first slide. And so then you're like, okay, I want to watch the Minion movie and go there. So that's how that works. I'm going to pause here and see, are there any questions in the chat, Sari?
Nope, you can keep going.
Okay, perfect. Don't think I changed anything, so I'm not going to save it. Okay, so here we are. So GoTalkNow, I'm not sure if people are familiar with it, looks like so. It is, you can get a free version. It's an app for an iPad. You can get a free version, and with that, you get 5 pages, which is definitely a good starting place if you're trying to figure out how to use it and what you want to use it for. A lot of people have traditionally kind of used it for some different communication kind of things. We are using this for all switch activities today. I do have one, my words page that you'll see as we kind of go through it. So what I want to do is I've made videos that I've put on here that we're actually going to play. Maybe not all of them, but several of them. But this next video is going to be how to insert a video that will automatically play in GoTalk and that will not go to all loop through all the other YouTube things that show up there. So I'm going to click on my link here.
Heidi, we did have a question I missed. I'm sorry. Back about the PowerPoint. So the question was, can you use the switch with boom cards in the same way you were using it with PowerPoint slides?
I'm going to guess yes.
Okay. Another question is, how do you choose from the scanning to choosing?
So mine is space is my mover right click is my chooser. So you would just put your, you know, if you're using a Bluetooth or a plug-in interface, you could that's what you would just set the settings to.
Great. And then one more. So they said the PowerPoint looks great. Is it easy to use it as a template and quickly switch out the pictures or videos for different days and different kids?
I think it would be. My hope was when I would get it working. I work in a Google district. So my hope was I was going to be able to get it going and I'd have a template and you could switch things out. And since I could never get it going in Google and none of my students can open it in Microsoft when I share it, I haven't dug further, but I'm sure you could quickly swap out photos. I just can't imagine that you couldn't.
Thanks, Heidi. That's it.
Okay. So we're going to watch this video. It's about 7-ish minutes long, but it'll walk you through the steps because then we'll go through and we'll look at what you'll see what's on my current iPad, and I'll show you some different things, and then we're going to add a page of commands on there when we're done here. Oh, hold on, I don't think I shared my sound. Able to automatically play in GoTalkNow. So we're gonna start right here and we're gonna go to Safari. And I already have found a video that I want about frogs. So I wanna record that video right on, what you wanna do is record the video right on the iPad, because if you insert the URL for YouTube, when you select that, when your Switch user selects that button. Oh, sorry, this is me. On GoTalk, it is going to open the URL, but it's not going to play it automatically. So it's an additional switch hit, and it's not necessarily in the place that you have designed for the Switch to be activating it. So what you're going to do is you're going to go up here to the corner, and you're gonna swipe down, and right here is a record button. So you're going to select the record button, then start your video. And you can tell it's recording because it's right here. To stop the recording, you swipe down again, and then touch the button. Go to my home button,
that face is expressive.
And I am going to close this.
One syllable at a time. That face wouldn't be doing that if you weren't staying at a verbal lake house.
And I'm going to open my GoTalk here, and I'm going to go to the page editor. So let's say this is my home page, and I want to do a page of animal videos. So what I'm going to do here is I can go to Add image, and I can either go to the GoTalk library. You can see right here that my screen recording was saved to my photos, so we'll get back to that in a minute. So I can go to the GoTalk image library, the symbol sticks library, or I can do an internet search. We're gonna do symbol sticks today. So let's see, we've got animals. Let's see if it gives us a good image of a variety of animals. Scroll down. Oh, I kind of like this one. Okay, now my button text, I can go over here, and you just want to type in what you want it to be. So we're going to do animals. Now, whatever your button text is, it will automatically speak that in the text-to-speech. So unless if you put animals and you want it to say wild animals, you're gonna need to go into the text-to-speech and add what you want. You can also add recorded video in here as well. So we're gonna push the done button, and we're done with our home button. So you can see on here, I have a variety of Switch activities that I've created in GoTalk. So we're gonna add a new page. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna, I'll quickly go through these so you can see them, how they're set up. So I've got my music,
my words. These are the 16 power words. A couple of animated short videos. Some fun YouTube kind of videos that are fun to watch. Some jokes that the switch user could ask Alexa to tell. Some books that I read aloud. And then I've got some voice activated toys that we'll be talking about. And then these are the commands for one of the toys and other commands for the other toy and another command for the toy. So now I'm at my blank page here, and normally you would just see a bunch of these buttons. So right here, I am gonna link my frog video. So first I wanna add an image, and I'm gonna do an internet search, and I'm gonna do frog. And I want to pick one that's going to kind of be fairly easy to see. Go with that one for right now. And then my button text, I want my button text to say frog. Frogs. Now in here you can change the color. You can either pick whatever color you want. You can go to some of the swatches. I'm gonna have it go ahead and be black today, but you can also make it transparent. So you can put in your word and the text to speech will read frogs, but you could also have it be transparent. So I think we'll do that. Done. Okay, go to my frog video, which is right here in my camera roll. I'm going to touch edit, and I wanted to cut off just a tiny bit at the end. So let's see. I want to go back. Let's see, right there. And then I'm going to do done. And so I'm going to save the video. Now, I'm going to go back to GoTalk. I'm going to touch my button. I am going to go right here, and I'm going to scroll over to video. I'm going to choose a video from my iPad's camera roll, and it's going to be the first video up here. So I'm going to pick it. I'm going to say use. You'll see that it's going to compress the video. And when it says done, you can add an action. Say after it plays the video, say you want it to jump back to the home page. You can click here and it'll go right back to the home page. So we're going to do done. Before we finish, we do need to go back to the home page. We'll go to page editor. We're going to go to animals, and we have to give it an after action, and we want it to jump to a specific page. And we didn't name that page, but I happen to know it's page 12. We're going to click done. Now we're going to click back to home and we're going to test it. So we're going to go to player. We're going to go to animals. I've got it set for switch access. So you have to tap animals twice. Here's our frog. And there goes the video.
Heidi, there's a question about recording.
Okay.
They're wondering where you found the record feature. They said they don't have one when they open the tools on the iPad.
All you need to launch a culinary empire. Tools you claim everyone has in their kitchen.
They don't.
is my
and a Squarespace website where you can brag about how.
If you don't have it, you're going to need to go into settings and control panel and screen recording. You can add screen recording to the areas that it'll let you do that. So does that make any sense?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, I had to go figure that out too. So that's how you add the video, and it's pretty easy. And it's just like I said, it was like, oh my word, I don't have to worry about YouTube not doing what I want it to do. I don't have to worry about, you know, if we're on the school Wi-Fi not having access to the video. So it's pretty sweet feature. And like I said, next time I try a PowerPoint book, that's I think what I would do instead of using directly YouTube. So I am going to, so the books that you put in, I want to talk about different switch activities. So you saw some of my pages were laid out with 4, some of my pages were laid out with 2, some of them 16, some of them more than that. So you can decide, okay, I think my, my child can, maybe just do 1. So we might have 1 activity on a page. And then I would quickly move to scanning to 2. And then, you can just keep building it. And, don't wait until they're like 100% mastered. I'm kind of one that I have high expectations. And then, if it's too hard, then it's my fault. But if it's too easy and I've kind of kept it there, then they get bored and don't want to stay engaged with the activity. So you can do books. You can just Google, go on YouTube and Google like whatever book they're reading. Storytime Online, you can put those videos in. Vooks, I think, has some free videos. So any of those kind of things you can, put in. You can do a screen recording of it and put it in as a book. So that's a way to kind of get, if they've got an interest, do lots of books about that interest. So music, I went into, we'll go back to, let's see if I can minimize this for a second. I'll bring my GoTalk over here. So I'll go to the player and kind of show you just what I have in here. So my music. So I just got some videos of some younger kid kind of songs. But if you have an older Switch user, you certainly can get YouTube videos of, age appropriate music for them. And then you can kind of see how it plays right here. We'll do this one because it's short.
Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes.
My music.
And then it goes right back to, so what I did this time is I linked it right to the My Music page so they could stay and listen to music on there. But you could also link it back to the home page if you wanted them to keep practicing navigating there. So I'm going to go home here.
My music.
Oops. So then the animated shorts, they're
animated shorts.
These were just a couple, again, that I picked. I'll play you a couple minutes of Piper. And just think about all of the ways that you could be modeling AAC here and language. Like look and go and oh no. He's looking and she's eating. I think he's hungry. Okay. So that's, I'm not going to make you watch, I'm not going to have you watch the whole thing because we don't have time, but you can, certainly look it up and see what you think, but it's just a great way to kind of model some really fun AAC things. And then in YouTube
favorites.
So that's an example where I have the picture of YouTube, the YouTube logo, but then my text to speech says YouTube favorites. And so I put a bunch of different things. There's like some crazy cat facts. There's kid president and balloon experiments. We'll do the skunk exercises because again, it's quick. And again, you can do lots of AAC modeling and chatting here as well. And then one of my favorite things to do is Alexa. to look at giving our friend Alexa some things to do, and mine will start listening to me here in a minute. So different things, you know, looking at, you obviously can't use a smart speaker in a classroom, but certainly at home, this could be some activities they could have. It could be a joke, the weather, sing, fun fact. I tested them with my speaker and they do work. You just have to spell Alexa with a U for it to recognize it. It doesn't recognize it with an A. So in your text to speech, that's how I have it spelled. Then my books. Again, two little, we got to Pete the Cat. It's always a favorite. And I did the screen
recording. Pete the Cat was walking down the street in his brand new white shoes. Pete loved his white shoes so.
And then back home. And then we've got our animal page. So that is some of the things you can do with that. I want to show you. Can you guys still see my picture, Sari?
Yes.
Okay. So I got a brand new toy yesterday who's a little robotic dog who can be voice activated. So I haven't put a page of commands in for him. So I thought we would quickly do a page of commands so you can see how quick and easy this is. So we are going to go to, let me just swipe down maybe. This never works very well for me. Okay, home, nope, we've got a, there we go. To get out of player, it's like a three finger swipe down and it's never the first time for me, unfortunately. So page editor, and we are gonna go to the, we're not gonna edit this one, we're done. We're gonna scroll over here till we get to the my toys. And right here, what I want to do is I'm going to have to add an extra button. So if you see right here, if you touch right there, we're going to have to go from 4 to 9, but it'll only show 5. So we're going to click on 9. And then we are going to tap to add. So we're going to add a button here and we are going to add an image. I'm going to go to the symbol sticks library. I'm going to search dog. We'll put this dog. And my dog doesn't have a name. I'm going to call it Robo Dog. All right, so that one is done. So now I need to add a sing a song, and I probably will just do one of these buttons, but here's, I'm gonna put sing a song. So you can preview it and you're like, yeah, that's okay. And then what you want to do is you want to link. So if you do nothing, it will go right back to this page so they can keep giving the dog commands. So you click done. We're going to go back to the home page. Sorry, page editor. Let's get to my page where I added my robot. It's probably a quicker way to do this. And so for this button, I need to have it jump to page 13. And so then when we go home, we go to player, my toys. So that is how that works. Let's see if I can scooch this out of the way. All right, questions. I'm sure there are a whole bunch. We went over a whole bunch of things.
Robot, and he is super cool. So the commands that Carl will do,
Carl,
include these. And so you can say to him things like
hello,
and he will respond to all of these. So here is a video of Carl responding to the different voice commands.
Hello.
You are so cute.
You are so cool.
I'm a zero.
Where are you from?
Venus Pogaloo.
I love you.
Boo-boo.
Let's do sports. Twist your waist. Sing a song. Sing a song.
All right. So now wouldn't you be like the coolest kid in class with that? So he is one of my favorites because he really responds to the voice commands pretty quickly and pretty easily. Any questions? All right. We're going to look at Coda, which is my little robot friend.
Kodo is another voice-activated toy. He runs with a remote control, or he has some commands that he will do that respond to computer-generated voices. So if you click on him, we've got it set with two taps because it's scanning in row and column. So here are the things that he will do, and he will respond to a computer-generated voice.
Handstand.
Let's watch Kodo do a few of his tricks.
All right, here is Kodo, and here is the remote. So you have to have someone pressing down the talk button right here when you give a command. And I have my GoTalk page here, so let's try this one.
Handstand. Say hello. Sing a song.
Okay, and then I'm going to show you one more, and these are really cool too.
Another set of toys that you can get, they come together as a set. It's this Transformer car and a Transformer fire truck. The Transformer car does not require you to push a button on the remote for it to recognize the voice output. Does respond to computer voices. The fire truck requires you to hold the button down on the remote control, but a peer could be doing that, so it's a great kind of engaging activity. They both have the same commands. I'm going to touch the car.
Race car.
And these are the different commands that you can give the race car and the fire truck. The video of these, I'm just doing voice commands with my own voice, but you'll get a chance to see how fun and motivating this act for a student using Switch Access and learning to do something that's fun and purposeful and meaningful. Forward. Stop. Transform. Dance. Dance. Transform.
So those are pretty awesome. They would definitely be the most popular kid in class. At the bottom of this page, there's a link for where to purchase things. I got Carl off of Amazon. He's currently $50 off. So he's only like $99 instead of $150. And you can get Kodo and the Transformers both off of Amazon. I got them at from Sharper Image because at the time I had a better deal on those. So questions before we move on to the power link.
The only question you answered was how to purchase those toys. So it's at the bottom of this Google Doc that you shared, Heidi?
Yes. It'll link to another Google Doc. And okay. The beauty of these is not only can you use them for like scanning activities, but you could use them for eye gaze students to learn on, work on, you know, improving their targeting skills. The other thing is if you have a, you know, although they have quite a few commands, if you had just, you know, someone who's only at like 2 to 4 buttons, you could pick 2 to 4 buttons, or you could let them pick what 2 to 4 buttons. You could use yes and no head movements to, you know, put on there. So you can definitely grade it and do different things. And they're just a lot of fun. My next favorite thing to make things kind of fun and crazy are is a power link. And I'm not sure if everybody knows what a power link is, but I'll go ahead and do, I'm going to just show you part of this video because I'll let you play it another time so that you can see what it is if you don't know.
Hi, today we're going to focus on how to use the power link for by AbleNet. If you're not familiar with a power link is a tool that allows you to make any device that plugs into an outlet switch accessible. So it has like these outlets. So what you would do is you would plug your device in there and then turn it on and then plug the power link on, and then the switch will determine if it's on or not. So there's different things. There's the mode bar, which moves you through direct, lab.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and stop that so we have time to see some of the activities. So again, I'm always looking at authentic engagement in academics and leisure and different things. And so here is a way to make science accessible, looking at predicting and counting and measuring.
So now we're going to do a little science experiment with the power link, and we're going to be using a blow dryer and a fan, and we're going to see which one blows the little ball the furthest. So a couple things before we get started. Fans and blow dryers are great things to use with your power link. Say someone wants to, you know, cool off or whatever, you can, they can independently kind of activate the fan. A blow dryer, another great option for a blow dryer is having the child be in control of the hair dryer when their hair is getting dried as part of their daily routine. So we're gonna go down here, and the first thing I need to do is turn the power link on. So the power link is turned on, and right now it's on direct, but for our science we want to know more than just like one press. So I think I'm going to do the mode, and I'm going to do seconds, and let's see, go down to 2 seconds. All right, and I have the blow dryer is hooked in with my jelly bean switch, and the fan is with my plate switch. So I think we're going to do one at a time so that it doesn't interfere with anybody's air. So I'm going to activate the green switch. All right, you can see where that one went. So now I'm going to activate the pad switch. Okay, so here is our data. So you could measure how long that is. So that is one type of science experiment you can do with the power link.
All right, so you can do, you can get as crazy and clever as you want. So like the second video is blowing 10 feathers off. So you could blow balls or a variety of things. The third one, I have a little bouncy guy, and that's what's being bounced off. The other thing is, I'm going to share this glitter lava lamp because I just really love it. And I think you can do some cool things with that.
I am going to show you today how to use, this is a glitter lava lamp. So the thing I like about the glitter lava lamp is it's immediate. So as soon as the student activates the switch, you get the glitter swirling versus a lava lamp. You have to kind of, a traditional lava lamp, you have to let it have time to warm up before the lava starts moving. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I am going to plug the lava lamp into the power link. I've made sure to turn it on. It's nice because they have an on-off switch right here. So I've got it turned to on.
Now I've got my jelly bean switch that I need to plug into the port that's on the side that I have the lava lamp plugged into. Then on the very back of the power link, there is an on-off switch. I'm going to turn that on. You'll see it light up. So a couple of ways you could do this. You could do a variety of things. It's some great sensory feedback for those kids who love sensory input, some great visual feedback. So I've got it on direct right now. So when I activate the switch, you'll see the glitter starts going. And then when I don't activate it, it goes off. And so if you're trying to teach students, you know, that when I activate the switch and make the glitter go, as soon as I release, it stops. So that might be for kids you're working on, like, just that sustained pressure so that they can, you know, activate the switch and hold it. Remember, you're never saying hit the switch. You're saying things like, let's see the glitter. Now, if you have a student who really struggles to activate it and stay on it, and you want to make sure all of that energy got the most bang for their buck, you could switch this over to a couple of things. You could either switch it to latch, which means that the lava lamp will go on and it will keep going until I stop it. Or you could do timed seconds. So again, you're gonna hit the mode button. Right now I have it for 10 seconds, but if you wanted to do something a little bit longer, you could do that, and you could always have like your AAC device and be talking about what you're doing, because that's like so much fun. So I'm gonna make the glitter go. And now I can take my hand off the switch and it'll go for 10 seconds. Another thing that I love about this lava lamp is it changes colors. So again, you could be working on a color unit and you could be talking about all the colors that the glitter lava lamp is turning.
Okay, so I'm going to stop that one there and see if there are any questions before we move to the next activities. Banners, look at the time here. The banners are just basically like banners you buy at the dollar store and you can hang along, and they swing back and forth. So there's a video on that. The animated light projector, I'm gonna show that because that's kind of fun. We'll show a little bit of that one.
Another super fun activity. For just some nice sensory feedback and to have control of when to start and stop, that is one of these light projectors. So this is like a Christmas light projector. It comes with different slides that you can put in. And with some of these projectors, you can order slides for all different sorts of holidays. So these ones are, the three that come with this one are all kind of Christmas or gift related, Christmas wintery. So I'm going to show you kind of how to do this, because it's kind of a super fun thing to lay in bed and watch and have some independent control over, or during break time. And if you have a student who needs to take a break out of their wheelchair, it gives them something kind of fun and entertaining to do. So here we go. So I have my projector here on the table and my jelly bean switch. Again, you could use any type of switch. And then we have the power link, which is turned on. And there's a couple of ways that you could do this. You could do a latch, which is what I'm going to do now, where it is on until you activate the switch and turn it off. So you could certainly model some AAC here and be saying like turn and on.
right, I'm gonna stop that one there. So the thing with the, if you get an animated light projector, make sure that you get one that has a, not one of the remote control ones, one that you just plug right in. I think that will work a lot better. I think a lot of us have used the power link for cooking. You can hook it into the food processor. There's a video of us making salad dressing here. You can use a stand mixer, popcorn popper, those kind of things. You can do tabletop bowling, but my favorite is leaf blower bowling. And if you click on the link that says leaf blower bowling, there's a whole thing from AbleNet that basically goes through their remarkable idea and has a whole lesson there. But here's a video of what this looks like.
This is by far one of the most fun activities and outrageous activities that you can use to teach students to learn to use different switch skills. So I have a leaf blower. They're $18.99 at Home Depot. I'm sorry, not at Home Depot, at on Amazon. And I have it plugged into my power link. I have the power link on direct. So again, that remember the leaf blower will operate as long as we hold the switch down. And this is leaf blower bowling. So you ready? I'm gonna push the switch. And look, we knocked four down. You have to kind of put something up against the leaf blower. You'll kind of figure out where you're doing it, which way it'll tend to veer. We've used it in a milk crate before and that works really well. Other fun activities that you can do with the leaf blower include you could make croquet hooks out of like PVC pipe or even like pipe cleaners and have balls that if the kids are, if the family's playing croquet, there you can use a lighter weight ball to go through those. You could also do a lighter weight bocce ball if your family plays bocce ball. And then they could be involved in that. And another super fun activity is stuffing scarves into the leaf blower and having it up on a table and shooting the scarves out for the kids to chase during PE or at recess. So those are some of the fun, crazy, and outrageous things you can do with a leaf blower that make switch activities super fun.
All right, so down here I also did a link that I found on YouTube of seven different fun activities to do with a leaf blower. One of them is blowing it at, you know, someone's face or their hair and making some distortions, and so that might be a fun kind of thing to do. And then last one I'm going to share, because this is like super easy, is a game day celebration.
Now in Seattle, where I live, we are big sports fans. We have the Mariners, we have the Sounders for soccer, we have the Seahawks, of course, for football. And all three of those teams, team colors, are some color of blue and some color of green. I know in many homes around our area, it is a big deal when we are watching either a soccer match or baseball or football game, and it's kind of a whole family affair. So what a here's an idea that's a great way to get your Switch user involved in game day. So what we have here is a power link, which is set to direct. And direct means when you hit, when you touch and activate the switch, it's the, whatever we're doing is only going to stay active as long as our hand is on the switch. Then up here, then we have a spool of lights, little twinkly lights that I got from Amazon that are blue and green. And I have them kind of around the TV. And I was thinking that this would be a great way to have
your Switch user be able to let everybody know that your team had scored.
The Switch, and look at that. I can be the one signaling the touchdown.
So again, another super fun activity that's really pretty inexpensive. You want to make sure you get lights that have an outlet. So a lot of those twinkly lights have batteries that go in them. So you want to make sure you get ones that have an outlet. And then down here is where to purchase the items. And I am going to stop my share.
Heidi, there's a question about what is Sprinkle a Little Razzle Dazzle that you have on your list?
Oh, shoot. I forgot that one. That one's like the best one. All right, do we have time to do one more?
If folks, it's 4:30, but people want to stay, that's great.
Where was my Sprinkle Razzle Dazzle?
There wasn't a link. It was
I forgot to link it. Okay, I'll tell you what it is. There's a video for it. I will get a link on there. As I was like going through trying to figure out what I had linked and I hadn't. I'll turn my video back on. That's what happened when I got kicked off. I basically have taken a blow dryer and I put the little attachment that's like narrow and I've stuffed it full of confetti. And on Broadway, they call that confetti, the little razzle dazzle. And so you pop that in the blow dryer and kind of prop it to where it's standing, whatever direction you want the confetti to go. And that shoots out and they shoot the confetti out and we all can stand a little razzle dazzle in our life. And it's a great thing to do with their gen ed peers because then they can go around and pick it up or, you know, anybody else can pick it up and work on their fine motor skills and stuff it back in. And then your Switch user can make it go again. All right, other questions? We can unmute people if, they want to unmute and hopefully you found